the enemy will enter into your life and take away everything God has given to you. Don't afford to lose him. That's why you need the Holy Spirit. It is he who will give you the wisdom. That's why we read in the book of Isaiah chapter 30 verse 20 onwards. When you wait on him, when you call upon him, you will hear the voice telling you, my son, this is the way. My daughter, this is the way. Yes. Some people even commit their life for God. Suddenly one guy talks nicely. One girl talks to you nicely. They forget everything. They become mad. Yes. They even leave their religious life and end up with a little world, with their little family. Yes. I know of a companion. He was a very good man, very good theologian. He got first mark in theology. But when he was working, he got a project, a so huge project. Suddenly love for money came into him. And the habit of drinking alcohol came into his life. That brought all the vices. One day he realized, I've got enough and more money. What will I do? Let me get married and be happy. That is the end of his life. The joy, the peace went away. His inner conscience began to prick. That money you are using is not yours. That money belongs to God. You are bringing your body is God's temple. You are destroying God's temple. And the evil spirit will come through alcohol. He became mad. When he became mad, the wife, the beautiful wife, he told me one day, she's an American lady. I married a foreign lady. She is mad after me. And my children are looking like Americans. Today, they all left him because he became mad. He was jailed in the USA. Became mad. He was jumping into a house. The dog bit him. And the owners came, put him into the jail, into the police custody. Hello, take care of your precious life. Take care of your soul. And only in the companionship of the Holy Spirit, your life is safe. You have to hunger for him. You have to learn to love him. If you don't love him, the love of the world will replace your heart. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Fourth, if you have to be received, if you have to receive the Holy Spirit, we read in the book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 15 onwards. He says, come to the altar with the priest and cry for your sin. He is a Holy Spirit. When sin is in you, that holy God cannot be with you. So come to the altar. Acknowledge your sin and cry for him. Lord, spare your people, Lord. Have mercy on me, Lord. Repent for your sin. Without purifying your heart, you don't expect the Holy Spirit to be with you. And if you purify your heart, the Bible says, verse 28, and then after the purification, I will pour out my spirit on all my children. If you don't purify yourself, you don't expect the Holy Spirit to come upon you. That's why in the book of Joshua, chapter 3, verse 5 onwards, today, if you purify yourself, tomorrow the Lord will do wonders in your life. Today, if you don't purify, don't expect the Holy Spirit to be part of you. Hallelujah. Shall we all stand up? How to live with the Holy Spirit? Though we may not be able to give everything, at least something, basic things. Lift up your hands. Hunger for Him. Number one, He is the companion. Like the physical life, God gives you the father, the mother, someone to be with you, a companion later, a son or a daughter when you become old. In the same way, your life is being attacked by the enemy every minute. You are living in a complicated world. You are living among people who are led with all kinds of things. If you have to live successfully, you need the heavenly companion, God-given companion to you, to be with you in your moment of cry, to strengthen you when you fall, to guide you when you take decision. A companion who can be with you. Yes. Understand, without Him, you can't live a Christian life. It is like a breath for you. It is like a breath for you. He is like a breath for you. Yet that's why Jesus breathed upon the disciples who were frightened. Before they receive the anointing, they have to come out of the fear. They have to come out of their worries. They have to come out of their lust for money, for power, for flesh. So Jesus breathed upon them and said, "Receive my spirit." Lift up your hands. You need this companion for your life. Without the Holy Spirit, you can't live a spiritual life. You can't live a meaningful life. You can't live a life. Second, the Holy Spirit will come upon those who hunger for Him. It is up to you. You can hunger in many things in the world. You can hunger for many things which are available in the world. Some are mad after the riches of this world. Some are mad after the dreams and to make their bodies happy. Some are mad after the flesh, the lust. Some are mad after to show themselves they are great. They want to achieve great position. They want to achieve great money. They want to receive great degrees. Nothing can replace the companion which Jesus has given to you. Nothing can fulfill what the Holy Spirit can do to you. Hunger for Him. It is your desperation for Him. It is your hunger for Him will bring Him to you. Third, if that Spirit of God has to be in you, He wants to make your heart His temple. You need to love Him.